welcome to Ma Vie en Musique, which is French for My Life in Music. I've always found people's sort of musical origin stories very interesting, like how they got into music, why do they choose snow and everything. And so I kind of wanted to tell my story and also, for those of you who haven't been here on this journey with me, tell a little bit about what I've been doing here, because Ephraim can sort of feel like a bubble sometimes. So as far as my musical origin story, I actually started playing bluegrass music with my family, and my first instrument was the fiddle. Now I play penny whistle usually on bluegrass music, but my mom learned every instrument she taught us. So she learned the bass, she learned guitar, she learned fiddle, like mountain dulcimer, mandolin, all this stuff. So it's pretty amazing. So please welcome my mom, Sally Crane, and my sisters, Celeste Osterlo and Amira Del Sol, to the stage. This next piece is the Bach Orchestral Suite in B minor. This is a really important piece to me because I used it for so many auditions throughout high school for pit orchestra, Sterling Scholar. I even used one of the dances to audition for my scholarship here, my very freshman year. And one of the dances is also like the first piece I learned here with my very first private teacher, Adrian Reed. So, and I always wanted to do the whole thing, and I always wanted to be able to do it with a string quartet, and I'm so blessed to have so many very talented colleagues here at Snow, so I was finally able to do that. So please welcome to the stage Rachel Papenfuss, Haley West, Abby Freestone, and Rebecca Vance.
Thank you.
This next piece is the Romance and Scherzo, and it's going to be dedicated to my husband, Britton, obviously, because the romance. But this piece represents to me the point in my college education where I met Britton, which was, I think, spring semester of my freshman year. He's nodding his head, he doesn't know. but Britton has really been a huge influence for good in my life, always pushing me forward. There are some pieces that I feel just don't have as much meaning until you've been in love with someone, and I think this romance is definitely one of them for me. Britton definitely taught me what love really means. And the second portion of this piece is a scherzo, which is usually like a playful, more upbeat, almost like the comedic relief of a piece, and Britton is definitely that for me as well in my life. Always making me laugh, always being silly with me. And Britton is actually how I met my accompanist, Kathleen Hansen. It's his grandma. She is not only an incredibly talented accompanist, she's retired now, but she's worked here for 40 years. And she's even in the Hall of Fame over there. And not only is she a talented accompanist, but she also made this dress for me, so she's a very talented seamstress as well. So I hope you all enjoy the Romance and Scherzo.
Thank you.
next piece is titled Marceau de Concours, which is just French for competition piece. This one's special to me because I feel like every musician, and maybe just artists in general, go through a period where they sort of get imposter syndrome. They're like, why am I doing this? Why should I make it into such a competitive, creative field? And it really sort of like weighs on your self-esteem after a while. But my grandma asked me to play this piece for her church congregation one Sunday. And it's really quite a simple piece. It's really pretty. And I even played it unaccompanied, so it wasn't anything too special to me. But afterwards, I had so many people coming up to me saying like, oh, that was fantastic. I even had one person ask me like, are you in the Utah Symphony? To which I replied, I freaking wish, but no. So this is just to reassure all those artists out there that no matter where you feel like you are in your art or your music, there will be someone who will enjoy it. So after this piece, there will be a 10-minute intermission, so please stick around.
Thank you.
All right, this next piece is called Jour d'été à la montagne, which means a day in the mountains. This piece to me sort of symbolizes the many, many friendships that I've made here at Snow, and many of those friends are here in the audience today. I've met so many people here that I will never, ever forget. And some of those people are the wonderful and talented flautists that will be playing with me on this. So please welcome to the stage Julia Lopez Hunter, Amanda Drake, and Anna Clausen.
Thank you.
Right. So last year I was lucky enough to take a songwriting class with Mindy Gledhill. And for my first song that I wrote, I kind of wanted to go back to my roots, which we now know as bluegrass. One of my favorite things about bluegrass is the downright morbid and tragic lyrics paired with such bright and memorable melodies. So I was really into literature and poetry in high school, and I noticed that a lot of like art poems and books have depictions of women drowning as though it's like a feminine way to die. So I thought, what a perfect morbid topic for my bluegrass tune. So here is Sweet Blackwater. Didn't know they taught the kazoo at Snow College. So my final piece is the Poulenc Sonata for flute and piano. To me, this one sort of reminds me of how I'm sure I will feel about Snow College once I leave. It's a sort of a nostalgic piece and a bit melancholy at times. I also wanted to do this because it's one of me and Kathleen's absolute favorite flute pieces. So. And I hope you will all enjoy, come with us and enjoy a picnic after this food will be provided. Just going to be over there in the practice field. So thank you all so, so much for coming. And thank you to all my fellow musicians who have performed with me today. Thank you, friends, and all loved ones for being here to support me both today and throughout my whole journey.